We all want, the highest possible return on any investment that we make. And there's a question of, first, what does IRR even mean, right? And the equation is long and complicated, but at the end of the day, it's providing somewhat of a time value of money over your returns. And the thing to note about, real estate acquisition investments is that, you tend to get somewhere in the low to mid single digits, cash yield in the early years of the project, increasing to high single, low double digits, over a 5-year hold. But the bulk of your return typically comes at the end of the project, right? When the property sells. And so it is important, if you want to smooth those returns out over the course of a 5-year period, to look at things on a time value of money basis. And there are always a lot of different aggregated, projection-based stats that we share when it comes to, looking at investment returns. Return on equity, average annual yield including sales proceeds, what have you. And so there are a lot of different ways to, look at projects. IRR in real estate tends to be that kind of default. Everyone knows it. We use it as a benchmark. And so there's always this benchmark effect that exists when you're looking at return profiles. And if you go back to 2012, 2013, 2014, you're going to see a lot of high teen, even low 20 IRR deals on, the value add acquisitions that today you might see, low to mid teens at best. And so, part of the challenge is again, being a human and not an econ, knowing that just because something was presented at 18 IRR 5 years ago, and it's presented at a 14 IRR today, doesn't mean it won't make sense in your portfolio. And the reality is that deal probably does make sense in your portfolio. It's just a matter of understanding, again, how to evaluate things on a risk-adjusted basis. The challenge that we all, or the way of thinking that we all follow, whether we want to admit it or not, is, again, that 20 IRR deal, if it misses, we think it's going to be a 17, a 16 at worst. And so why wouldn't we go for the 20 IRR deal if the worst case is a 16? But we all know that at the end of the day, if the 20 IRR deal misses, because we are using leverage, because we're overexposed oftentimes because of our use of leverage, that if the 20 IRR deal doesn't hit, it's going to be a sub 10, could be a loss of principal depending on the project. And so it all goes into the larger question of how to look at deals on a risk-adjusted basis.